another motherfucking day. You know what it is. New York City, campaigning. About to do my Jason Bourne for president shit, man. I told people, I'm back with my old school hunger. Shit that got them blog of the year type of thing.
The homies with me. Money plus, man. You
know BX. BX. Guy J. Reed. Flow Empire people. Showing us love. BJ the DJ. Wire Radio, man. Fuck with us, man. A plug.
Let's go, Jason Paul, what's up?
What's up with you? What's cool?
I'm good. How you doing today?
Man, I'm cool, man. I'm blessed, man. I'm good every day, man. I woke up today. It's a good day.
Definitely is. I see you on everything, man. You're moving out here real great.
Man, I'm just trying to stay active, man.
That's a good thing for some people that don't know you. What exactly do you do?
Oh, man, I'm the plug. You know what I'm saying? Okay. I do a little bit of everything. I'm a blogger, host, you know what I'm saying? Media consultant. Yeah, a little bit. Anything media, you know what I'm saying?
Gotcha.
I try to keep my hand in everything.
Yeah.
You know, my passion and everything started with the journalism. You know, I write for magazines, different blog sites, you know, senior editor of Rider Magazine.
Okay.
You know, I also run the day-to-day of the label, you know. Shout out Platinum Boy Music, my brother Amadeus, Uncle Mike Ab, you know. Okay.
So how did all that come together? Because you work with Amadeus, he's a producer, then you got the blogger, you a journalist. How did everything come together? Because that's a lot of stuff in one. That's like a big mixture.
It all started with the writing.
Okay.
You know what I mean? I was shout out to Parlay Magazine, you know, Kevin Benoit. He gave him my first shot. You know, to write articles and stuff. So you know, as you started just maneuver through situations and meet people. You know, it's all about networking.
Definitely.
So, you know, this person to connect you to that person.
Yes.
You know, so that's what started happening. And after a while, people would just say, yo, you know, I got this idea. Go put it on paper.
Definitely.
You know? Then once you put the idea on paper, they want to, you know, get you to help them bring it to life visually. You know what I'm saying? So you start doing it like that.
Gotcha.
So you know, just communications, networking, you know, being relevant.
Definitely,
yeah.
That's definitely a good thing. So,
well,
Amadeus, do you
manage
him, or how does
that
work?
I run the label, Platinum Boy Music. You know,
so when you say you run the label, you like you're the president. Like what's your day-to-day roles of running the label?
Shout out to Royal Guard. He's the president. I'm the go-to guy. I'm a general manager, so it's kind of like, you know, the details, the logistics. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
What we gonna do? How we gonna do it? When we gonna do it?
Definitely.
You know? That's what my task is. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Then now, you got Uncle Mike. You know, he does all the marketing and community affairs. You know what I'm saying? And then you got Eb. She's the queen of Platinum Boy. She keep us together. You know what I'm saying?
Good, good.
She the one that said, "Listen, hey guys, remember we gotta do this time." You know, so she's the glue.
Gotcha. So how hard is that? Because you know, like a lot of people don't know how to run a label and putting everything together and being a go-to guy. How hard is that, and what does it exactly entail? Like, give us some details, like some things you go through day to day.
The hardest part is the, you know, the standard that, you know, my brother Amadeus set musically.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? That's the hardest part, is just, you know, find artists that live up to that. You know what I mean? Because, you know, accolades aside, you know what I'm saying? He's a multi-platinum producer, but accolades aside, he's really a musician.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So his ear for music is really dope. So, you know, with me being, you know, in the blogging and in the streets a lot, I run into artists all the time. So, you know, a lot of times people think that it's just like a no-brainer to connect the dots.
Yeah.
You know, and say, oh, you know, sign me the Platinum Boy, but it's not that easy. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, we need a star. You know what I mean? We like every other label. You know what I'm saying? You think anybody else, you know? The CMGs, the MMGs, the Dream Chasers, you know what I'm saying? You think of all of them, you know, it's definitely about the bottom line at the end, you know what I'm saying? And you know, when you get the machine got to have a good product.
Definitely does.
You know what I mean? And then this, you know, in this climate of hip hop today, it's about really doing business with an artist, not so much signing them. You know, people ain't really getting deals today.
Yes.
You know, it has a blueprint to it. You know, you go to a production company or a management company, you know, and they'll get a check for their and your talent, you know what I'm saying, that you're able to put out music, you know what I'm saying? It's all about distribution and, you know, things like that. So that's really what it's about, you know what I'm saying? We're not like a staff of 100 people where, you know what I'm saying, it's like this major budget just sitting there and I can just push the button and release anybody's music today. You know, it's not really like that. That's a lot of red tape, a lot of, you know, dotting I's and crossing T's, you know what I'm saying? And we all, we all have a say so, you know? So it's not like, you know, I'm just sitting here saying, yo, I want to do this tomorrow, let's just do it. Nah, you know, we got to bring it to the table.
Okay.
And really see if it, you know, if it benefits us, you know what I'm saying? And if it lives up to the quality of, you know, the level we're trying to operate at, you know? We're trying to compete with the winners.
Definitely. So you say you're looking for a star.
Yeah,
now, what is a star in your eyes? Because you were a platinum of music groups. You were Amadeus. He worked with a lot of successful artists. What is a star in your eyes? Because you work with a lot of independent artists. So what is a star to you? Like, what are some star qualities?
I tell people to, you know, operate as if you're already where you want to be.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I see artists who, you know, they want to be dope. They drop a record. They don't make a dope cover for it. Okay. You know what I'm saying? They might do a show. They don't bring a dope cameraman with them to catch the footage. You know what I'm saying? They're online. They're not finding dope ways to approach their marketing or their branding process. You know what I'm saying? So a star to me encompasses all that. You know what I'm saying? They understand, you know, their talent level. You know, they understand their goals and they understand what it takes to get there.
Definitely.
You know what I mean? And it always starts with the music. You know what I'm saying? If the music's not dope, you know, you can't just like, you know, put somebody in a pot and stir it up and make a star. You know what I'm saying? They say like stars are born, they aren't really made. You know what I mean?
Okay.
You gotta just have that it factor. You know what I mean? So it's definitely somebody with dope music, a dope look, you know what I'm saying? A dope work ethic, you know what I mean? And go about it in a way that they really connect with their supporters and know how to, you know, bring on new fans as well.
Okay.
You know what I mean? And supporters and stuff like that.
So, is there any artists right now you're working with?
Yeah, man, I got this thing called the Commission.
Okay.
You know, that's Tuck, the Strills, you know, that's Simba Saint. You know what I'm saying? That's Westside Parlay, that's St. Jude. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I also work with a dope ass artist out the Bronx called Hop Cachet. You know what I'm saying? Pardon me. Hop Cachet, you know, 682 Varsity Entertainment. You know what I'm saying? I work with Nate Nils. Got some dope people with me, man.
Okay, so how did the Commission come about? Because that's a tough name right there.
The Commission for me, it just got to a point in time where like, I knew a lot of dope artists and I kind of just felt like everybody was missing the same thing, which is really the support aspect. You know what I'm saying? I find a lot of artists that they just don't know how to connect with each other. You know what I'm saying? I say all the time, like, we don't get dope records, like big records with a lot of people.
Yeah.
You know, I was watching this Khaled interview and he was saying that one of the things he found was his niche of how to put dope people together. You know what I mean? So for me, I always said that could be me right there. You know what I'm saying?
Definitely.
Find a couple dope people, put them together. You know, if you got 10 people, you got 10 people, you got 10 people, that's 30 when we come together.
Definitely.
You know what I'm saying? Add yourselves, we make 35. You know what I mean? So, you know, the game is going towards movements, you know? So you got to be able to come in here with a large voice. You know what I'm saying? It's always going to be strength in numbers.
Definitely.
You know what I mean? So you can do that. And, you know, really push each other, you know what I'm saying? That's how the Commission came together, just with all of us coming together and just identifying that we all had something in us.
Gotcha.
You know what I mean? We all wanted to do the same thing, so we just pushing each other.
That's a good thing. So you've been in the game for a while, safe to say, some over 10 years?
Nah, man.
Who's asking?
Hey, it's so funny, you know how they, like, online, they got this thing called, they got the share your memories.
Yeah.
My memories only go back like 4 years, man.
4 years. No, that's good.
Yeah.
So 4 years you've been in the scene
to
today in the independent market. How do you feel it had changed or increased?
Oh man, you know, so quick, I was thinking this the other day. The artists, and I'm speaking like for, you know, the level, you know, this you're saying this indie/underground.
Yeah, indie/underground
New York City.
Yes. New York City was.
The guys that was hot 4 years ago ain't really relevant today. It's like, I don't know why.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I think that today is just too many people that just feel they could be a star from their computer.
Okay, you're right.
You know what I mean? Like, it's just like, you just want to spam me to death on Facebook, like, or Twitter. Like, yo, listen to my song. I'm like, okay, I'll listen to it. I like it. What else?
Gotcha.
Where can I see you at? Where can I feel you? Where can I touch? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
No homo, where can I touch you at? It's still about that.
No, I agree.
You know what I mean? Everybody that was great, you was able to touch them.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They were able to really, like, follow their path. You know what I mean? Like, I'm big on campaigns. I watch everything. You know what I'm saying? Like, when I'm home, you know, I'm not out in the street running around, I'm home, I watch campaigns. You know what I'm saying? That's where my where my passion lies. That's where my intrigue is at.
Yeah.
And that's why I can say, like, listen, you know what? I like this artist because I watched them go through, you know what I'm saying? The greatness of putting it together.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, you know, I was just saying, I was talking to my brother yesterday. I was like, yo, it's crazy. You know, Kiss is coming out right now. He got the top five, Dead or Alive.
What you think about that?
I'm watching this whole campaign, and it's just like, it's just giving me a whole different feeling about,
yeah,
you know, music again. Definitely about New York City, you know what I'm saying? Like, I grew up in that era of listening to Kiss, you know, watching Kiss, you know what I'm saying? My first car had every D-Block mixtape, you know what I'm saying? I had all that, so to see him doing it again, it's like, it's big for me, and I just really hope that people are paying attention and you realize that this is what it takes. You know what I mean? Like, Instagram is cool, but you still gotta get out on the street and work. You know
so
what I mean?
Good thing you say Instagram. Do you feel Instagram is hurting the music business or is giving the extra bonus?
I think that when you speak to the experts, the music business is not about Instagram. It's on like Twitter more.
I agree with you, but I'm talking about.
But is it hurting? I think it gives you a false sense of security.
Yes.
In terms of like, you know, really saying like I made it, you know, because I got I put up a pic and I got 150 likes. Cool, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But it's always gonna be you know, a different conversation that you might not be a part of.
Yeah.
You know, like I tell people a lot, as a journalist, I'm able to get into rooms that, you know, a lot of people aren't able to.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? We get into those listening sessions.
Yes.
You get into those real release parties, though. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Those real, where it's executives there. A lot of these guys that get a lot of likes is not part of the conversation.
So when you say a lot of executives, what's some of the conversations about? What are they thinking?
Oh, man.
We don't get a chance to see that or hear that often.
I know for me it's a blessing. I've been able to, like, you know, have a conversation with Kevin Lyles.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? And that's like, man, the stuff he talks about, I just be soaking up game, man, you know?
Gotcha.
Guys like him, Bull, Nigel, you know what I'm saying? Even D Dot, you know, the Hall Pierre, I just soak up game, man. Like, when I'm around them, I'm like, man, you know what I'm saying?
What's some words that they tell you? What's some dollars that they giving you?
They tell me it's all about quality, it's all about relationships, it's all about consistency. You know what I'm saying? Understand your brand, you know, and understand the way to market it. You know what I'm saying? And they always tell me the especially Walter Jones too. Shout out to Wave, you know, that's one of my mentors.
Shout out to Walter.
He always tells me to be very careful about what I attach myself to. Because, you know, it's unfortunate that, you know, if I'm ever, you know, if God allows me to get to where I want to go, I won't be able to take everybody with me.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
They're beautiful
so
that.
They always say, you know, be very careful about that. Because people will soak up your energy, man.
That's very true.
You know what I'm saying? They're soaking my energy. I think, aside from them, the best piece of advice I ever got was to stop standing behind the camera. I remember, like, about 2011, 12 maybe, I used to go hard just like pushing other people, you know what I'm saying? Like, yo, you need to really listen to this and watch this. And they used to be like, yo, they ain't really as interesting as you. Like, you know what I'm saying? So you like, you gonna kill me, keep trying to like, listen to this,
do that.
You know what I'm saying? And, you know, my story's kind of deal. You know what I'm saying? So I think a lot of people, you know, they really got that story.
So we want to know your story. What's what we want to hear?
Man, I'm from Dykeman. I'm from 200 block. You know what I'm saying?
What's 200 about? What's that?
That's Dykeman. It's Dykeman Project, man. 200 block. We go 200 block. That's 200 Street in Manhattan. You know what I'm saying? I'm from there, man. There's only 7 buildings. You've never heard of a rapper coming from Dykeman Project. You know what I'm saying? Somebody already did. You've never heard of, like, somebody make it to the NBA. You know what I'm saying? From Dykeman Project.
Yeah.
It was hard, you know. All we had was us, you know. We had to, you know, get it how we live, you know. I definitely, you know, I used to run around a little bit, you know what I'm saying, in the streets. I done broke my head, you know.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You know, I'm trying to stay as diplomatic as possible,
clean, you know.
But I got the story like everybody else.
Yeah.
You know, the majority of things that these rappers are talking about, I could probably say, no, that was really what I did. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
People that could vouch for it. I was at a day party on Saturday, right? Anybody from Harlem, anybody that you know that was, you know, from that lifestyle, you know, I relate to these guys, I grew up with them, you know? That's what I was doing, unfortunately. But, you know, I woke up one day, and I was like, I could do something differently.
Definitely.
You know what I mean? I was tired of giving my time to the wrong people. You know what I'm saying? The wrong things. I got tired of somebody telling me when I can and can't do something. You know what I mean? So I just flipped it around and I said, hey, I could apply the same hustle to this. You know, and it'd be real. And you know what I mean?
So have you ever been locked up?
Yeah, man, I tell you a story, man.
So that's the after you got locked up was when it was really realized like this ain't where I
want to
be at.
Yeah, you ain't gonna be able to keep doing that. Yeah, man. That shit is gonna be over. You know what I mean?
Gotcha.
I remember, I'll tell you straight up. They said, man, the regular guys is having all the fun. They're around.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like straight up.
Gotcha.
They're around. So I'm a regular guy now.
Yeah, that's cool. That's definitely what's up. So when did you meet Amadeus?
I knew him since we was about 13 years old.
Okay.
Yeah, I know him for a minute, man. I tell people all the time that, you know, he always been nasty with them drums and always had, you know, his ambition. You know, at that age, music wasn't my thing.
Yeah.
So, you know, I'm not gonna even sit there and say like, nah, I was the guy passing out the flyers and interning and trying to get them to hear my music. Nah, man, I was the guy trying to do something else, you know? Like I said, I was a basketball player, so I was trying to do that.
Okay, once I stopped
playing ball, you know, I was hanging out with the people that your mother told you not to hang out with. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So it wasn't really music for me. It's funny, Beans, right? When Beans first got with Rockefeller, one of his verses, he was saying like, he was saying something to the effect of like, it wasn't his dream, and he didn't even work for this. He was saying like, he feels sorry for those that did. And I'm not saying that I feel sorry for those that did, but I could definitely stand up here today and tell you that, like, this is always my brother's dream, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to Twin, you know, Georgetown. This is his dream, like, you know what I mean? We was in high school, he was, like, reading magazines. Like, I'll be going to get something to eat, he going to get a Sprite, a bag of cookies, and a magazine. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
The Source, the Vibe, Double XL, whatever it was, you know? So this is always his dream, you know what I'm saying? And I just watch him go hard for it, you know what I mean? And then, you know, I got into it by cabs. I got into it just by writing. You know what I'm saying? My uncle, you know, we was in a situation where we had to figure out how to do better. Uncle had some ideas, you know what I'm saying? He said, you always been smart, man. Like, you know, use it. You know what I mean?
Definitely.
You're too smart to be stupid.
Yeah.
In fact, here, take this idea, write it. And I wrote it. And I was like, oh, shit. I kind of could put words together. You know what I mean? And I got to a point where I saw that, like, a lot of my friends, you know, that I was doing, you know, the wrong things, but couldn't really read and write. It bugged me out.
Yeah,
because I was like, damn, I always could do both.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? You can.
I've been on an honor roll everywhere.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I graduated from Portsmouth Abbey High School, Rhode Island, man. It's 450 people in the school, only 12 black kids. You know what I'm saying? My classmates, they went on to be, like, that line in Drake, you say, my classmates went on to be chartered accountants. My classmates really went on to be chartered accountants, really. Yeah. Graduated from Ivy League schools and, you know, all that type of shit.
Gotcha.
I went back to the hub and the towers dropped. You know what I mean? And I just...
How was that? You know, from being at a good school like that and then going back to the hood? Because you were in a different environment, but then you back in the hood environment. How was that transition?
It was easy for me. That's where I'm from. You know what I'm saying? I just went right back to it.
Gotcha.
I mean, in hindsight, I could say it probably wasn't the best decision. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I put up the other day, I said, I'm Dykeman, it's Carlton Hines. You know, everybody know that story, you'd be like, damn. And even to speak to that too, because me and Chase Money was just talking about it in terms of like my name, like online, you see this Basquiat.
Yeah.
People like, damn, I was the Basquiat, Jason Bourne. You know, if you know that story, you know, the fame killed him.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying?
So that's the fame killed Basquiat?
Yeah, you know what I mean? He was, you know, famous painter, Andy Warhol's understudy, you know. He the night before his gallery was open in Seoul, he overdosed, you know what I mean? He just got too caught up in everything else except, you know, the work of it, you know what I mean? So for me, I just said, I'm gonna grab that name because it's like, I can't never allow myself to get caught up in everything else, you know? I made a promise to myself that I would learn how to, like, sit down. I remember, like, I could have cars, some money, the rent is paid. I'm trying to think of something else to do.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But now it's like, man, everything good, I'm going to go sit down and watch YouTube.
Thing.
You know what I mean?
That's a good thing.
Straight up.
So at what point did you meet Amadeus? I mean, not point, but this time
working together. Back to working together.
Yeah, y'all working together.
I was hosting Greenhouse. He was the judge.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? We reconnected on a music tip. But I already saw him at, you know, like different events throughout the city.
Okay.
But to clarify, him and Sin the Saint were like best friends growing up. You know what I mean? So every time me and A up against each other, you know, Sam, it's no secret. You know, he just did 6 years. You know what I'm saying? I used to write him in jail, but like, yo, I just saw A. You know what I mean? But when you get back, it'll work itself out. So when he got back, he connected the dots. And I was hosting Greenhouse. And he had another event to do that night. So I was telling him, I was like, oh, you know what you missing? He was like, what? I said, me. And he was like, why? I said, everybody got somebody that makes it happen. You know what I mean? There's no Hov without Lil Yachty or Tata. There's no Puff without James Cruz or Gabby. There's no Rick Ross without Gucci Pucci. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I was like, I'm going to just be the Gucci Pucci of it. You know what I mean?
No doubt.
Guy you don't ever really got to see, but, you know, in order to make it happen, you got to call him.
Gotcha. That's how that real
thing, you know what I mean? And he was like, all right, let's see.
Yeah.
And he just, you know, started seeing how I move and how I do it, you know? And then one day we had a conversation and he was like, yo, you know, I got all these credentials. People want to work with me, you know, because like, they want to get down. Like, you don't look like you want to get down. I'm like, I don't need to get down. Like, you know what I'm saying? I'm doing me already. I'd rather us put it together and make it bigger. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I see your vision, you know? This label, Platinum Boy, you know, it could be something. You know what I mean? I want to be a part of making this something. I don't want to just go, you know, I could run in Atlantic and beg them to give me a job, you know? And if my credentials line up, they might give me a shot. But I'd rather be the guy that, you know, built Cash Money before Cash Money was millionaires. You know what I'm saying? So
that's what's up.
That's my thing.
So with the whole Platinum Boy music group, like, do you have any artists at this current time besides who you're working right now?
We have Tiffany Mignon. Shout out to Tiffany Mignon. You know, she's our artist. Outside of that, it's more on the production side right now.
Okay.
You know, my task is to add the artist to it. That's why I said earlier, you know, I'm really looking for somebody that's really dope. It's more just the production, you know what I'm saying? When you look for the credits, you're gonna see Platinum Boy music in a lot of records, you know? You know, my brother got records with a lot of people.
Yeah.
J-Lo, The Game, to CeeLo, Talib Kweli, Tiger, Chris Brown, you know what I'm saying? Trey Songz, all those records, you know what I mean? So that's really what the strength of PBM is right now.
That's what's up.
But you know, for 2016, I'm gonna open the door up, you know what I mean? Yeah. But we need an artist, you know, in order to fully become a label.
Gotcha.
We need an artist, but you definitely gotta do it the right way.
Yeah. Are you looking for any artists outside of New York, or we keep it only in New York?
Man, we just dropped a record with Katie Soriano in Minnesota. Okay. She's dope, 17 years old, she can sing her ass off. You know
that's
what's
up.
So we definitely not, we looking for wherever it's at. You know, this is home, so we would love for it to be, you know, from New York first. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You always wanna do what you gotta do home, you know what I mean? There's no nothing without New York City, that's where we're from. You know what I mean?
Fact.
But if it just so happened that somebody in Oregon got some shit,
yeah,
you might be signing a motherfucker from Oregon.
Gotcha.
You know what I mean?
Gotcha.
It is what it is, you know?
Yeah. Is there anybody in the industry that you wanna work with or you wanna meet that you haven't met yet?
Anybody I wanna meet that I haven't met yet.
Somebody that could give you some more diamonds.
Man, I think I might wanna hang out with Jay Prince one time.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Really, okay.
What's so interesting about Jay Prince?
It's the, I guess I would say like the law. He's like, he's always there, but not there.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And everybody respects his credentials and, you know what I mean? And from a business standpoint, he's been able to, you know what I mean? Really solidify himself, you know what I'm saying, in the business. I love, you know, to meet Dr. Dre, T.I., you know what I'm saying? I love to meet, I love to go hang out with Nori, you know what I mean? Pusha T, you know what I'm saying? He's this guy that I, you know what I mean? Kanye, from a musical standpoint, everybody say he's a genius.
Yeah.
I could agree with that, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Some people I like to hang out with. You know, it's like a, it's an ill question, because I, like I said, you know, I remember one time I said I wanted to meet Sway. I've hung out with him multiple times, you know what I'm saying? That, to me, I felt like I made it, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
I told my mother about that one, to be real. You know what I'm saying? I wanted to meet Kevin Lyles, hung out with him, you know what I mean? I wanted to meet Jada and Styles P, met him, you know what I'm saying? So it's like everything is kind of lining itself up, so I'm just trying to find, you know, somebody else. Like you said, get some game, right? Dr. Drake, sure, he got some game
definitely
for me.
Definitely got some game for
me, you know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? All of these, I've met these people, I've met Mano, I've met, you know what I mean? I was a big Troy F fan, hung out with him. You know what I'm saying?
So if there's one artist that's signed right now that you met, who stands out the most?
One artist? That's,
I know it's a hard question, but I know you met a lot of artists. But if you could be, you're narrowing down to one artist, who can you say stood out the most?
And I had a conversation with 50, Jada, and Styles all at the same time.
Okay.
That was big for me.
That definitely was.
You know what I mean? Yeah, you know. Yeah, that conversation we had was really dope.
Yeah.
I'm a Yo Gotti fan, you know what I'm saying? I was on stage with Yo Gotti, me, him, and Busta Rhymes, you know what I'm saying? That was big. You know, Ty Dolla $ign was standing there with us, you know, Fab was there, 50 was there, you know what I'm saying? So it was amazing. You know, I've been blessed, you know what I'm saying? We've been you know, powerhouse, summer jam, you know what I'm saying? So these is like dope moments, you know what I'm saying? You know, we was in a section with Floyd Mayweather, so I mean, you know, it's just, it's cool.
You're moving pretty good.
I mean, it's
moving
blessing.
Great.
God let us do it. So
that's what's
so good. You know what I'm saying?
Moving great out here.
It's cool.
Yeah.
How's Cash BX, you know?
Yeah, that last record, that's that Hot Cash A joint, man. Cesspool, the video's out online right now.
Check it out.
Definitely check it out. The project, Liquor Stores and Churches. You know, we got that coming in December.
Liquor Stores and Churches.
Yeah, you know. You know how that go.
Like that.
Man, that brother really working, man.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna lie. We was hanging out this weekend. We was at the hip hop press conference in Newark.
Okay.
And I was telling him, I said, man, you know, for me, when I work with an artist, I always try to find somebody that challenges me, you know, to give me like more content than I can handle.
Gotcha.
He said, I got you. So I ain't gonna lie. Like, we're dropping a project in December. The brother has given me like 4 videos.
So.
3 freestyles, 3 records, you know what I'm saying? To the point where it's like it's a machine, like we're in sync now, you know what I mean? Like, he's shooting a video, I might not be there, but somebody else is handing in their phone, like I would handle my phone if I was there. You know what I mean? Taking the pictures, the behind the scenes, you know, we got the blogs going crazy, so I definitely want to shout out Strategic Films, you know what I'm saying? The whole 682 Varsity, and I want to shout out my guy, Hop Cache, man, they just shot the, Believe It or Not video yesterday in Patterson, Jersey.
What's up?
You know, we got the behind the scenes on Street Chemistry right now. I had to check that out.
Okay.
So we just working, man.
Shout out to Jersey, too.
Yeah, shout out to Jersey, man. That hip hop press conference was really lit. Yeah, man. Shout out to Spliff Star. He got, you know, his label, Paper Rock.
Okay.
They was in the building all heavy. You know what I mean? And they was just doing what they do.
That's what's up.
Shout out to the brother Fontaine for bringing me out.
Yeah.
Shout out to Chase Baker for connecting the dots, you know what I'm saying? We was in Newark, man. You know, we was in Hop Cache backyard, you know what I mean? Shout out my brother Tuck, straight from Trenton.
Yeah.
You know, he jumped on that turnpike and we was just out there doing what we do. You got that loaded up, it's good to go. You got that BX shit from the homie Chase Money Plus.
I hope so.
Got it.
Yeah, go
loaded
into that. It's loaded.
That
it's
right
loaded.
Now.
All right, now we can get into that got that Parlay Parks. I know you got that 718, like the wall is in your joint. We can get into that afterwards, but I definitely wanna play that Chase Money Bus joint, man. You know, he been rocking with me the whole night, showing me a lot of love, so I wanna play that record, man. Well, make sure y'all follow him, man, too, man. Instagram, Twitter.
Chase Money Blush_Chase_Money_Blush, you know?
Yeah.
Follow me, man. We out here.
And I want to thank my guy, BXJ Reed, too, man, on the camera, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? Y'all looking for y'all videos, y'all vlogs, your photo shoots, anything you need, man, from a visual standpoint, man, at BXJ Reed, man. You know what I'm saying? He showed me love. You know what I mean? Person I can just. One phone call away and he there for me. You know what I'm saying? So I need y'all to follow him, man. At BXJ Reed, man. If you're not following him, stop what you're doing now and follow him.
You got some shout outs?
Yeah, man. I'm going to shout out the motherfucking 200 block, man. I'm
excited, man.
I want to shout out Home 14th Street, man. 7th and 8th. Shout out Patton Boy Music. Shout out the Commission.
Yes.
Shout out to BX. You know what I mean? I just wanna shout out to man, EJ the DJ, man.
No doubt.
Empire Wire Radio. You know what I mean? Everybody that's rock with me showing me love, I wanna shout y'all, man. I appreciate you.
Yes.
You know what I mean? If it ain't for love, I can't do it. So I wanna shout out everybody hustling too.
No doubt.
My brother M Easy, I was on the phone with him today. He got about 6 more summers. All he want me to do is talk about the hustle when he called.
What's up?
Shout out, you know, my cousin, you know, Scooch, you know what I mean?
Chase Money. Listen, I said, I done hustled, robbed, scammed, yeah, I'm with that. Niggas be
telling us no love for your snitch ass. I'm in the slums with niggas throwing bullets where your wig at, and letting niggas know you get money, get your kids snatched. My right hand man up north, jail where you live at. See the indictment, he took 12 on the chin strap. Talking cold on the phone, ain't really with the chit chat. Talk crazy on the line, how to get your shit tapped. Feds be listening, really, I ain't trying to add that. Remember when we used to do numbers like NASDAQ in front of the building, ain't go home to the last pack, man. Catch a bright cruising up in that black lap on the strip club, throwing dollars out of strap stack. Real niggas first, fake niggas get laughed at. Bitches get exposed on camera just like they cast stacks. Balenciaga box in my closet, that's where the gas at. Yeah, that's for that dirty money. Strap right beside it, that whole 30 something.
And I am the plug. We out at New York City, man. Grind never stops. Another day on the radio. Shout out to DJ. Floor Empire Wire Radio. Got my guy BXJB with us. You know, we're gonna go ahead and do what we do, man. Stay tuned.
Yo, you know what it is, your boy EJ the DJ, live in effect. Dope ass interview with my boy the plug, Jason Bourne. How we do, man? We just having a good time. We young New Yorkers having a good time, taking it to the world, internet status. Fucks with me. You know, EJ the DJ, Jason Bourne, two young niggas getting money. Holla at me, you know what I'm saying?
You know what it is. Gotta be in the streets, man. You gotta rock with the people, man. And you gotta hang with the bosses. I need to drop from Slim. Go
back. Hello, people. How are you? Great. Shout out to Jason Bourne. He's the plug.
Another successful night. This is what we be living for, though, man. It's just, I don't know, like, wake up and do this. Go to sleep thinking about it. Man, that's just what it is, man. I'm just out here working, man, trying to stay relevant, man, I'm trying to be above, trying to get to what we're doing. 200 block, man, BXJB, dopest motherfucking cameraman in the world. That's what it is, man. Stay tuned, man. We got more radio stations to kill. Connect with the dots. You know what I'm saying? More tapes to drop, more articles to write, more interviews to do. We're with you, man. We love you. You love us, man. Love. Beat.
Was deeper than some change. Found his body in the water with his money and his ring. He got caught up in some shit. Started fucking with this chick every day.